Hi everyone, I'm Kenneth and here is my second video on framing the problem. In an earlier video, I discussed how to do setups, which are essential for first proposition and first opposition speakers. This video will now talk about another crucial aspect important to first speakers, framing the problem. So what is framing the problem? Typically, proposition is trying to propose some change to the world we live in, and opposition opposes it. So proposition's job would be to say that there is something wrong with the world right now, and opposition's job is to either say that there is nothing wrong with the world, or that proposition's solution makes it worse. This video will thus focus on a generic three-step framework that can be applied to proposition or opposition. 1. Obviously, is to say what is wrong with the world or your opponent's policy. But you have to be careful of not just stating the problem, because stating is not merely enough. You need to describe the problem and prove its significance. Otherwise, your proposed change is not meaningful because it does not solve a major problem. An example here is a debate about whether we should have separate gender categories for award shows like the Oscars. Proposition, we have to identify the problem. So, a male-dominated industry that places higher standards on women who want to win the prize than men. Hence, women are less likely to win if they competed against men. Then, proposition should elaborate on the consequences, such as harms to their careers, a lower earning potential, being seen as worth less than your male counterparts. The second step is to substantiate this problem. Now, here is where you want to come up with the causes for the problem or structural reasons as why the problem continues to exist. Note that this is important because later on, you can link your solution to how they tackle these structural reasons. Note that these reasons should be related to the solution you're proposing, therefore. In the same example of separate gender categories, a reason could be that the entire industry, from directors to producers, are male-dominated, and hence support notions that men are better actors, or that women can only play certain roles, otherwise they are not good actors. 3. You now need to pile pressure on the other side to respond to your problem. This is something that should be part of framing the problem, but is often rarely utilized, which is to engage the other side, even if you're prop one, by casting doubt on the potential solutions you have. So opposition in the above debate might choose to go for something like organic change by saying the film industry is already liberalizing and therefore there is no need for separate gender categories by proposition. Proposition should then say, since Prop 1, that such a liberalizing trend takes too long and places an unfair burden on women right now to live without equal opportunity. So this allows Prop 1 to directly pile pressure off the problem onto first opposition right from the start of the debate, even if you have not heard your opponent's case yet. This is a strategic maneuver that will be very essential in ensuring that you're able to advance your side's case as well as pile pressure on first opposition to respond to its entire form. So I hope this has been useful. Thank you for watching.